By putting FEMA in the lead, the president has emphasized that our response to the coronavirus is in the anthem of FEMA. It is locally executed, state managed, and federally supported. We want the people on the ground, the decision makers, to have what they need. We want states to be able to manage the unique circumstances in their states.
There. So, what's up? I have a lot of people asking me and wondering about me and what I study about Thelema and occultism and living in northern Alabama in the Bible Belt. You can imagine words like this, magic, ritual, incantations, stuff like that would be interpreted as Wiccan or satanic. And this couldn't really be further from the case. The English language is so bastardized, and it's just so hard to actually articulate and get ideas across in our language that don't scare people who already have some type of preconceived notion about the stuff. And it's understandable because I was one of these people. Growing up in a Baptist church as a Christian my whole life, I used to think that this stuff was off limits, negative, bad, just like the complete epitome of evil, so to say, and I want to kind of clear some water for a lot of people, and especially about myself. I am not a Freemason, but I study the philosophy and the work and the craft of it, and that all kind of started after people who know me, what I grew up and went through with my family, that whole negative experience, if you want to call it that. If it didn't happen, I wouldn't be where I am today. It kind of propelled me to where I am. And you would think, as long as humans have existed on this living ball flying through space, circling the sun, that we would have already figured out something to, make our lives easier or maybe a little more manageable with less anxiety, depression, and have found some outings, if you want to say that, to kind of help this and your psyche, your mind. I'm going to try to keep it as baseline as possible on this stuff, and if you don't know some of the words I'm saying or some of the jargon I'm using, it's going to be kind of harder to ascertain, but just bear with me. This stuff will be learned over time. As with me, I've only been studying Thelema for probably like not even a year, but so much progress, and this is my own anecdotal experience, has been made, and for each individual, it's the same thing. We're all on an individual path, so to say, or experience, and the sum of that is our everything we know to this point. Our whole entire makeup, what I think is me, Caleb, all that has happened to me sums up that total experience into what I think I am. But on its most baseline, and for every human being and everything that exists, is a connection or a parallel to divinity, so to say. So I'm going to give you some books that I started off with that kind of really help, because no one, if you just get one, you're going to read it, and like me, I can tell you this, you're not going to be able to really apprehend anything that's being said. It's going to be kind of like a bunch of nonsense, so bear with me, and if you're one who really kind of wants to look into this, you're watching this video for some apparent reason. So here we go. One of the first is this big beauty. Gems of the Equinox, and this is a publication by Israel Regardi on Aleister Crowley's Equinox, and the main axiom of that entire publication, which is like 10 books, or I guess 10 entire books, which is a whole bunch of occult material, is the method of science and the aim of religion. And you would think, okay, with the method of science, we can be logical and analytical about this and actually have some backing information and some evidence, some empirical evidence. And then as for the aim of religion, if for any religion, what would it be? Self-awareness, seeking divinity, making yourself a better person, whatever you want to fit into that category. We have this, and religion's been around for as long as human history has proceeded. There's been different cultures, different interpretations, different teachings, different prophets, Christ, Muhammad, Buddha, Krishna, I guess, which is like Jesus in the Hindu idea. I'm not really sure about that, so don't take my word for it, but there's parallels in all of this, and it's supposed to be a type of guideline to look at and interpret all of these and get yourself somewhere to where you want to be. No matter which one fits, none of them are wrong. They're all existing for a reason. There is, in Islam and Christianity, two of the biggest ones, I guess, tyrants, if you want to call them that today, fight against each other, and the main point at this point is like against Allah and God. Both Kabbalistically are the same thing. It's divinity. It's something incomprehensible. We can all agree upon it if you are, I guess, not an atheist or someone who has any idea of religious philosophy. There's no difference. I mean, the teachings parallel so much. And if you study Aramaic, Arabic, actually read the Torah, the Quran, the Bible, the real Hebrew Bible, and interpret it in the Kabbalistic sense, you start to see those parallels. And Gems of the Equinox, this big beauty, if you can get your hands on it, would really recommend, because it helps a lot in understanding all of this. Another one, more for practice and your own experience in meditation, if you like meditation. If you're like rituals, which is something I've been getting into, and believe me when I say this, when you actually do it and implement it in the psyche, you're programming your consciousness. And when you work on it and actually start building upon that and these foundations, you'll actually start getting somewhere. And a lot of people don't realize this, but you can teach spirituality the same like you can an instrument or a language, and a lot of people really don't know that, and they don't practice enough, believe me or not. I am not a Christian. I really don't label myself anything. If you want to call me something, it'd be, the closest would be an occultist or a Thelemite, but I don't really go out bragging about it or say anything about it, because it's like, I know what works for me. If anyone asks me, I'll tell them, and my own experience is the sum of that. It's what I can say has happened. And with anybody else, if they tell me something, they've experienced something or happened it, I can't say that's not true. One, because I'm not them. Their experience is the sum total of what they have seen and felt, in a sense. So for practice and to get a better idea, book 4, Magick, Aleister Crowley. This thing is a frickin' beast. I would have to say this is one of the best books to have, if any, for practice and for understanding about what magic is. And I'm not going to get really into it. I'm just trying to give you guys some books and an idea about all this stuff. But magic would be everything. And science today, I guess I should elaborate on that. Science today is just accepted magic. You know, you used to turn on a light bulb back in the day, or have like some type of electricity current, or have something levitate. People would call that magic. And today, science, anything that we can prove or do, put forth enough effort and know that it works logically, is magic. I can do this, I affect matter, my consciousness, every human being that has free will and can think, affects reality, and can do just about anything with your free will. Do what thou wilt is the whole of the law. That's the one of the biggest, Thelemic axioms. And I'm trying to keep this video short, so I'm sorry if this is dragging on, but the sum total of our experience, a lot of people don't know this, when you sit down in a quiet room and relax, try to forget about everything, you'll come to realize that you're back again at a singular moment, and that your experience is a constant flow of undulating vibrations, waves, and stimuli, sight, smell, taste, hearing, everything, and that all equals consciousness, or your experience right now at every present moment. So, not to get too philosophical or deep, the last one, this is a dictionary, one of the best books I'm actually starting to appreciate, Liber 777. It is a Kabbalistic writing of Aleister Crowley, and this one book has three books in it, actually, Gematria 777 and the Sefer Sephiroth. And if you don't know these words, I can tell you, when you start doing research and understanding them, it's going to make a lot more sense. But this book has been a big help in understanding Hebrew for me, Greek, and Kabbalah as a whole, Tree of Life. Most of y'all know what that is or have heard about it. It makes a lot more sense about all that stuff, because a lot of people today on YouTube and in the spiritual community or whatnot are selling an idea or maybe a thing to try to get people to understand or do and implement to make their life better. These are people just trying to make a business and a market, and you really don't need anything. What you need is yourself, your thoughts, and some time alone to study and sit and do it. I mean, find something that feels like it's progressive, that it's growing on you, and it will be so rewarding in a way. And I guess the main ending point of this video is to kind of say, like, I can only speak for myself on the stuff that I've read and what I study. And if you've made it this long in the video, I can end it by saying this. If you study it, try implementing it, and are serious about it, you won't be disappointed. And you'll start seeing coincidences or synchronicities appear almost instantaneously and everywhere. It's almost to the point where it gets scary. But enough of that. Peace, guys.